Hello and thanks for tuning in. If you're joining me again, thanks for coming back. If you're new to the channel, please hit the subscribe button so you can stay up to date with all the videos. Alright, today we're diving back into the Supercharger, and this is the M45 Eaton Supercharger, commonly found on Honda's earlier model D-Series. So this is the inlet tube with the bypass assembly, bypass valve, and the common S-tube. And the throttle body. So we'll talk about the throttle body and the S-tube restrictions and issues I see in a later video. Right now we're going to focus on the throttle valve there, the bypass valve, and the actuator itself. Now when you get these, normally the nipple up there is broken, or the diaphragm's inside and it doesn't hold vacuum, or they're rusted closed. As you can see, mine is nice and lubed up. I cleaned everything out. Got some dry lock lube in there on both sides. Still a little carbon. I haven't fully cleaned it out yet. But in a normal working supercharger application, under vacuum, while you're sitting at idle, I'm going to draw about 15 hg. You see the valve is open. See the valve be open, just simulating that you're idling. So at this point, you're recirculating the boost. So you're dumping the boost back onto the non-charge side of the supercharger. And then if you hit the throttle, that closes and allows you to build boost faster. So a lot of times people disable these and everything. I'm not here to say whether you should or you shouldn't, but it was there from the manufacturer to make the car spool quicker, get better gas mileage, and I'm gonna leave it and it's working perfectly fine. Like I said, a lot of times you'll find them busted and they're, you know, $150, $200 to get them used. And I'll show you again. This one's doing just fine. I'm glad. So we're simulating idle conditions. And if we hit the throttle, it would close. So you're not recirculating boost anymore, and you're building boost. Otherwise, at idle, you're bypassing boost because you'd be fighting the engine and the brakes if you're stepping on it with this thing closed, and you're building boost constantly because it's a belt-driven supercharger. All right, so to test your bypass valve, bypass actuator, you need a vacuum gauge. You're just going to pump it up. Open the valve all the way. And let it sit. Now naturally it's going to want to close because it's under spring pressure, and there is slight leaks in between, you know, plastic and metal interference, but if it's holding like this and going back slowly, the valve is generally good because the engine's going to be constantly producing a vacuum. It's if you have it like this and you're squeezing and this valve doesn't move at all and doesn't hold itself. So mine starts opening at about 4 inches of mercury. And at about 10, it's fully open. And I can get it to 15 while I'm pumping it. Let it go. And it'll slowly go back. That's really the only check you can do on it, other than making sure it's not rusty. And I put a little bit of supercharger needle grease on there so that it don't bind up. I also adjusted the stop valve on it to right before it hits. It's got just a little bit of movement in there and does just fine. Looks like before, whoever had it adjusted open way too much and it was resting. Should just barely be touching that stop. Alright, we'll get it flipped around and look at the inside. Alright, we got the S-tube and the inlet with the bypass valve and actuator assembly turned upside down so we can look inside and see. It's a very minimal porting that has to be done. It's not too much. I'm gonna get all four bolts in there and see. And I'll probably just smooth the inside of this out for a good transition. So let me get them bolts in and let's see how much we actually got to take off. Okay, so we got all four of the bolts in and just slightly hand tightened. I mean, it's a little loose, so I can move it and see. And let me zoom in. There we go. I'm going to move it around so you can see there's not much that has to be taken off. And it's a step coming in, so there's really no like wall or blockage because all the flow is coming up through this pipe and out this side. So I'll get the grinding stone out and just take a little bit off, but I don't see any reason to open up this port anymore or this port. Let's flip it around and look at the throttle body side. Okay, this is the throttle body side. So stock, these things are 66 millimeters. And this is just a stock D16 Z6 throttle body. 66 millimeter. And again, it's fairly close. I got an aftermarket 66 millimeter one. It's billet aluminum, so I'll put that on here. And then I'll see if I actually got to do any smoothing or anything in there. But yeah. That's the end of it. And let me get this thing set back up so we can talk about the S-tube. All right, here we got the S-tube. And if you can see, it comes in. The air would rush in through here and it hits a wall. It has to come down, hit another wall, and then go into the supercharger to get compressed. There's a couple companies out there that make or are trying to make new S-tubes and everything, which is great. Hopefully we'll see those soon. This was designed strictly to bolt onto the OEM Honda system. I don't think Moss Motors or whoever owned Jackson at the time. It may have been Jackson themselves. This was supposed to be just a bolt on and go, you know, 75 horsepower, however much it put out, you know, at 6 PSI. So I've been thinking maybe in the future I'll cut and bring this down. You know, just bring this whole section down and get rid of that bend. But for now, I'm going to leave it alone and just do a minimal port out of the throttle body, match it with the new one I got, port match this and port match the other ones, and just have everything port matched and smooth and operating like it's supposed to, so it's a fun, enjoyable daily driver. This is not going to be on a race car or anything. It's just going to be a daily that gets good gas mileage. So yeah. Stay tuned for the next video where I port match everything and start making gaskets for everything. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe.